partnership is going to work.
Yes.
You know, in the future, does this mean Waymo trucks on Uber's network?
Yes. So we, Waymo, will partner with carriers and shippers, and they will have trucks with the Waymo driver on them. Yeah. Our fifth generation driver is what we're using right now in Daimler trucks. And then those trucks, shippers and carriers, will have the opportunity to opt in to the Uber freight network.
And, you know, paint the vision for us. Yeah. These are trucks that are taking anything you can imagine, crisscrossing the country, the world.
Exactly, long-haul trucking. So massive long-haul truck across, say, Tucson, Arizona to Houston, or Dallas to Houston. Major, major shipment of goods across the country. And the reason this is so important is we've reserved the capacity for billions of miles on this network because we believe, as two companies, that we can improve the efficiency of how goods move.
So Uber and Waymo, long ago rivals that date all the way back to Travis Kalanick, the co-founder of Uber, and Anthony Lewandowski, co-founder of Google Car. Like, how did you get past a really long and drawn out lawsuit?
You know, I'm really happy to say that the Waymo Via team and the Uber Freight team have focused on what we actually are here for, right? Which is improving road safety, improving this long-haul trucking and logistics opportunity. Yeah. And Dara and I have, from the beginning, had a really good sort of upfront and direct relationship, which I appreciate.
So let's talk about how far Waymo has come, because I rode in the Google car in 2011.
Yeah.
And just a couple of days ago, my colleague Tom Giles rode in the Waymo of today. How much has that experience changed in 11 years? This is 2011.
Yeah.
That's today.
Yeah, this is today. Yeah. So today we have the fifth generation Waymo driver, which is what you see on the all-electric I-Pace. Yeah. Here in San Francisco, we have employees who are taking rider only, which means no human behind the wheel, rides, and we have members of the San Francisco community also taking rides as trusted testers. In addition, we've announced that we are expanding to downtown Phoenix, where the same vehicle is there, and our employees are taking rides. And we've also started having employees take rides to and from the Phoenix airport, which is really exciting because it's the first time that any autonomous vehicle company is figuring out how to navigate an airport.
So, and I know I ask you this every time we talk, but I guess the real question is, when can I, in a major city, open an app and hail a Waymo?
So, right now you can, in the Phoenix metro area.
Right, and you're doing limited testing in San Francisco, but when does this become more
available?
Mainstream? Yes.
Available. So I think, you know, what we're really focused on is, what does it take to go from one city to now three geos, one platform to now across multiple platforms? And that's what we've been able to do. One of the things we've learned in doing that is it's operating a service that's actually the learning curve, right? Yeah. You've got to learn how to not just make sure the technology works and is safe, but how do you delight the riders? What does that experience look like? And so one of the areas that we've found wonderfully delightful is when people are using ride hailing and there's no driver in the car, or no human driver in the car, the Waymo driver only, they immediately start casting their music, right? Those kinds of features are what allow people to come back and feel like this is their third space. So the question you're asking is, what's your roadmap? And I'm not telling you that, but what I am telling you is we're spending time learning a lot. And in Phoenix metro area, our service has been up and going almost 2 years now, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and those riders continue to make it a valued part of their
so
lives.
So what's going to differentiate a Waymo from a self-driving Tesla, from a Zooks, from, you know, there are all a bunch of different companies, Aurora now working on self-driving technology.
Yeah, I think you'll have to see what those companies are really focused on, that really important first step, which is getting to removing the driver.
Yeah.
As we all remove the driver, and we've done that now a couple of years ago, then you figure out what your value proposition differentiation is going to be. I have no idea what theirs is going to be. I just know what ours is.
How about regulators? How much progress do you really think you're making on getting regulators comfortable with the safety of this?
So the safety is really the focus of the federal government. And so right now it's largely a permissive framework where companies have the opportunity to submit a safety report. There hasn't been a lot of detailed movement at the federal level. The state level, there has been, and we, you know, our teams work with all levels of government. And at the state level, as we're even seeing here in California, the states, both legislators and regulators, are trying to figure out how best to advance this technology while doing so safely.
How often do you get to ride?
I love to ride. So when I go to Phoenix, every time any family member says they're going to be there, any friend, I try to go and take a ride. And then, of course, now that it's right here in San Francisco, I do rides often.
And are you, like, taking notes and sending them back to the team?
Of
like,
course.
Here's what
of
we
course,
need to
yes.
All right,
of
all
course.
Right, all right. So let's say 5 years.
Where's 5 years
Waymo?
Out?
Where's Waymo in 5 years?
In a lot of cities.
Mm-hmm. How many? Like 10,
I don't know.
12,
I don't know. In a lot of cities, and also, you know, we have ride hailing. We also have the Class 8 trucks, so our trucks will be on roads, moving goods safely. And then we have local delivery. And so, you know, your meals, your groceries are hopefully coming to your house in a Waymo, too.
Is this going to go global? I mean,
definitely. Okay. We're focused on.
Is there a market that is more exciting than another internationally?
There are a lot of really exciting international markets.
Right, because the question is, how does this scale,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I think that's right. And we're in the early days of focusing on that right now, scale. You know, and operating across 3 geos and 2 platforms is the beginning of learning what you have to do, all the rails that have to be laid in order to do that.